the time's getting close. I'm here with Comedy Central's Dave Attell.
Hi.
RETRO MYRTLE BEACH GUY, and it's day two of Chili Fest. Shelby car show going on out front here. There's at least a couple old ones. This going on today. Tomorrow it's the Antique Car Club will be here. Probably a little bit more speed.
So we're gonna have two competitors up here, and we're gonna do a chili cook-off, right? Please welcome Kim Eccles, our pro today. Eccles, thank you so much. In addition to all of those things, she's also a really, really nice lady. All right, our Joe, here we go. Joe is the local ABC 15's chief meteorologist.
Joe!
He got his degree in meteorology from NC State University. He's never, ever cooked chili before. I don't know if that's true. Ed has been named Best of the Beach 17 years in a row, and in 2018 was named Myrtle Beach's Citizen of the Year. I wasn't eligible that year. Please welcome Ed Piotrowski. Ed, nice to meet you. How are you feeling today? No hurricanes. You can't share the kitchen with her. You have your own kitchen over there.
Oh yeah, but now we put all the ingredients in before anything is hot.
That's a good point.
Failure is not an option, Ed.
All right.
I'm doing a good job at it though, Kim.
Right. Now I just do want to point out to you that you have another pot that we're going to eventually put this in, right?
Okay.
Yeah. And actually, these are the traditional, you understand, those are traditionally
right.
The spices and stuff that's used for chili.
I haven't used it yet.
We haven't started that.
Do we have to use, like, all the pineapple? I mean, all of it's got to go in there, right?
Half, Ed. Were you listening?
At least half.
Oh.
Yeah. It's looking...
He's not pulling any punches.
It's really looking Hawaiian at this point.
It does.
Yeah.
We're going to see how it goes.
All right.
All right, why don't you try it? See what it needs.
Oh,
oh my gosh.
We're just going to go with it.
All right, let's... It doesn't need any more salt, Ed. No more salt, Pete.
No, but I need more pineapple.
It's actually not bad.
Okay. All right.
I kind of
like
it.
Let's add some more good stuff to it.
All right. I think it needs more bush beans, to be honest with you.
Ed, what is your signature chili ingredient or technique?
So, I love Spam.
Okay.
I grew up eating Spam, so it's a flavor very familiar to me. So, I've never had it in chili, though, so that's kind of neat.
Okay. Well, it doesn't seem like... Okay, go ahead.
Here we go.
Add
a little bit more.
Very good.
Oh,
if you got beans and meat, you've got a great start.
Let me just say this. It's starting to look a little bit more like chili.
Yes.
Except for the giant pieces of pineapple.
Mark, can I get a
semi-Brian approved. That's awesome.
Yeah, semi. Do you know what I did? This is true. I, a recipe that's in my book, I'm hoping to meet Chuck Edwards today. I had his chili last year. I loved it. It's a chicken white bean chili. I made that
And and then the next day we actually used it to make enchiladas. So there you go. That's that. Right. To your point.
With my leftover chili, I make nachos, but that's what the kid likes. He likes to make nachos with it.
Okay.
I make burritos with it, and I'll roll it up, and I'll put them in the freezer with cheese, and then roll them all up and put them in the freezer. It's a good pop-out lunch when you need a quick
lunch.
There you
go. All
right. I put it on top of scrambled eggs, so you can put it on top of a cheese omelet or like a Western omelet. Three? Okay.
30 seconds. 30 seconds.
Mark, you can't see that for another 90.
By the way, I just saw Ed use his finger to take the sour cream.
You're welcome that I did.
Off the top of it.
He's using his finger, he's double dipping the spoon. We're rolling. That's it. Cheese going
wild. Wow.
All right, so.
Look at this.
Somewhat nice presentation? No.
Somewhat nice.
All right.
I'll give you the somewhat. All right. I'm going to not let this burn so you can have this. Cold. You can take this home later.
Family's going to love me.
Yes. Okay. Let's start with you, Ed. Okay. How confident are you feeling right now?
Not confident at all.
Okay.
She's great. These guys have already kind of looked at me funny, so I think I'm in trouble.
You think you're in trouble. Okay. Let's present these to the judges so that there's no mistaking.
There you go, ma'am.
These are the Joes. This is the Joes chili. Absolutely. All right. Can we have a little... Yes. We have a little discussion about the consistency, what it looks like first.
Please do say a prayer.
John is praying for both of us.
I appreciate it, John.
Yeah, Brian, so I go for catch, color, aroma, texture, taste, consistency, heat.
The I'll catch. Oh, I haven't heard
catch.
That before.
Yeah, that's my okay. acronym. Like that? I trademarked it. Don't use that. So I'm going to say color. Interesting. Interesting. It's kind of got a brownish, reddish, yellow thing going on here.
Okay.
Aroma. I just smell salt. That's great.
Small. Is there a lot of salt in there?
I'm hoping it's not the chili. That's only the hair.
Okay.
Here we go.
I just got
cold. Use your hands again.
Oh my goodness. And all I smell is pineapple. And I better not get sick if that double dipping.
You won't.
Okay.
All right.
How come she got Fritos on top?
I forgot you were
added bonus.
I can bring them over with my hands.
No, put them in your mouth first and bring them over for you. Appreciate that. Here we go, Johanna.
All right, go
God
ahead.
God bless you.
Go ahead, try it.
Okay.
God save them.
To be completely honest, it's not terrible.
It's not terrible.
It's not terrible.
Terrible.
There you go, man.
There you go.
I haven't gotten a large chunk of pineapple or spam, though. That was just the base layer, but...
That's the chili magic.
That's the chili magic. Here we go. Big boy bite.
Yeah. Okay. I don't yet. Not okay. All right.
The pineapple, the ham. I mean, pineapple and ham is a great combo. Never had it in chili before. Better than I thought, Ed.
Okay.
Okay.
Say, that's no green screen talking. Here.
Okay.
That's live.
How are you doing, Johanna?
Johanna's still not sure.
I'm surviving.
You're surviving.
Not good.
And it's interesting. And I will leave my comment at interesting at this point until I try the pros chili.
Okay. All right. Without the competitors seeing.
I don't know how we do that.
Write down a number on your on your thing. We're gonna this is the Joe's.
Turn around, Joe.
All right.
Jen.
I'm allowed to look. No, it's fine. I'm good. I'm good right now. I'll try it later. They're setting some aside for me.
Good.
Ed, just know I always love you.
We've been friends for a long time.
Okay.
We hurt our friendship.
Make sure you don't rate it too high. We need, you know, in case the pros is better.
It can't be.
All right, here we go. Here's Kim's chili.
Okay, Kim, thank you.
Can I try yours, Kim?
Of course you can.
All right, here we go.
Okay, well, Kim, it looks more like a chili. I'm a chili purist, so let's try it and see what happens here.
There's nothing to about
good handiwork, the nice work on the small chunks of pineapple. I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
Everything's a nice bite-sized piece there, and it's sauteing the spam and the pineapple together. Actually, nice touch.
Thank you.
Did you hear that?
Yeah,
sauteing.
Basically, I've lost
something.
Yeah, it's. Kim did a good job. The seasoning is really well balanced. Ed's was balanced as well, to be honest. But this is really
the seasoning was balanced.
Was balanced, yeah. balance can be balanced or unbalanced. There's always a balance. Right?
There's always a balance.
All right. The suspense is literally killing me. Can we see the scores?
First
for the Joe.
For the Joe.
For the Joe. And the judges say?
Five.
Five and a half.
Five and a half. Well done.
That's out of ten.
Out of ten.
I'm a strict judge.
So that's over half. That's a 10.5. My math is right. That's a 10.5. Congratulations on that. You got, that's a passing grade, I guess.
I'm a legend in my own line.
Yes, well done. All right, and now the pro.
Definitely legendary.
And now the pro, what do we have for the Spam Pineapple Chili?
Oh, no. I scored Cam an 8.
An 8?
For balanced flavor.
Wow, well done. For the balance.
Well, I scored Kim a 5. Ed, yours actually tasted better than me.
Oh! Listen to this.
I love Kim. I'm all about girl power, but Kim, yours was too salty for me.
Okay.
And even though you had better knife work on your pineapple and your Spam, overall, Ed, you did a better job in my humble opinion.
It must have been that finger salad.
Thank you.
And he just gave literally $2. $2 for a compliment. Well done, Ed. But if my math is right, it's still Kim is the winner. The pro beats the Joe. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I've been told $1 million was taken off of the table. However,
I'll take $500,000. That's okay.
An amazing gift bag here from Bush's Beans. Ed, you also. For winning.
Thank you, sir.
A Myrtle Beach inspired gift package there from the World Championship Chili Cook-Off. Thank you, everybody, for indulging.
It's pleasure.
I think it's the right word.
Stars in her eyes, tongue full of flies. Would you like to share my past?
Crow, 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 bullfrog in love. Crow, 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 bullfrog in love. And I gave her the crow to mean I love you.
I'll be your croak, monsieur.
I'll be your croak, my dad.
Your mama might say that bullfrogs are dumb, but I'm here to tell you that I am a frog. Come and sit on my log, you little polywog.
I find you absolutely riveting.
Croak, 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 bullfrog in love. Croak, 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 bullfrog in love.
Croak, ribbit,
scoop, splash.
You're about to get married, right?
Yes, sir. The night.
All right, now. You got one? That's your one right there.
I also think your character is one of the more complex in the show. I really got into it.
Thank you.
Awesome. So how can people find your book, Ryan?
SeriouslyGoodChili.com. Thanks so much.
Awesome. Thank you. All right. Lifelong dream accomplished. So speaking of our upcoming nuptials, one of the more fun things to do when planning a wedding is coming up today, so we're at Croissants Bakery. Picking up a little sampler set, and we're gonna do a taste test to figure out what kind of cake that we want. We're pretty sure we know already, but they got such good cake, why not try them all? So yeah, right next to Hook and Barrel up here, we got Croissants Bakery, which is one of my favorite spots for coffee and a croissant in the morning. Really good pastries, really good macarons. They also have like a really great patio and seating area inside. It's a really nice place. And I haven't been to Hook and Barrel at all yet. We'll have to do that one night. It's a very popular spot.
All right, so the fall weather is actually starting to catch up. It's still warm, but there's a nice cool breeze. It almost feels like fall here. It wasn't unbearable being at Chili Fest all day. It's definitely top-down weather. if I clean all the loose paper out of my car, I would have had the roof down. Oh, I gotta clean this thing out. It's full of like empty oil bottles right now. A little bit of an update actually on the Corvair. So we've been kind of piecemealing, you know, fixing this, fixing that. We basically fixed almost every individual part on the engine, and there's still leaks, there's still issues. So we're just gonna put a whole new engine in. Jerry right now is working on rebuilding one, and we're gonna have a fun shop day because we're gonna drop the engine out of this thing and put in a brand new 1964 Monza engine. So that'll be fun. It'll be a little bit more reliable. Not that it's not super reliable already, but a lot less little issues popping up because it's gonna be a whole rebuilt engine dropped in. I'm very excited. That's gonna be a fun day. Here because Ed Piotrowski, our local weatherman from the chili contest earlier, alerted us all to the fact that there is going to be a launch tonight that might look pretty cool. So I'm meeting Tiki down here. We're gonna see if we can get this space launch on video. A big day. Getting close. I'm here with Comedy Central's Dave Attell.
Hi.
What's up, Tiki?
Doing all right.
We're hoping to see this rocket at some point tonight.
Yeah, 7:32 apparently.
I've never seen something like that before. like a rocket.
Oh, and that means I love you. Yeah, I read my baby loud and clear.
It's hot, 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 hot.
She just said, I love you, dear.
It's hot, 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 hot.
Now when I reply the way I do,
it's hot, 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 hot.
I just said, I love you, too.
It's hot, 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 hot.
Eat, ah, oh, ah, eat, ah, oh, ah, eat, ah, oh, ah, ah. That means I love you. Come on, fly with me. Up high with me. Come on, fly with me. And now, e-bop-bop means I dig you. You heard the word. And that crazy word. And that word you hate. E-bop-bop means I love you. Hop on, baby, I'll put you in orbit.
We come to a decision.
Yes. Red velvet with white chocolate.
The white chocolate. It did look good. They were all good though, right? You liked them all?
Oh yeah, yeah. Just the white chocolate one. The white chocolate was so creamy. And it just, it really, the red velvet.
I was rooting for the cream cheese, but I think she's right.
No, the cream cheese was good. It was just like a close second.
All right, well, that'll wrap it up for us today. What a crazy big day. Until next time. Say bye, cat.
Bye.